Hello, hello, welcome back to WebSense Pro. So in today's tutorial, we are learning how to create development store for Shopify. So you might have seen multiple tutorials where I am showing you guys how you can add shop products in Shopify store, how you can customize your Shopify store, and etc, etc. All of those changes and edits which I'm doing is in development store. So development store is used for two purposes. One is if you are a developer and you want to learn something, and if you want to test a code, and if you want to test a Shopify app, you can create a development store. And the second purpose is to build a store for your customers, build it on development, and then transfer the ownership to your customer. So in this tutorial, we will learn how to create a development store. If you want to learn, please stick to the tutorial. Without further ado, let's jump into it. Before we proceed to the tutorial, guys, I would like you to request press this red small button to subscribe this channel. It's not gonna cost you anything, and it will give you loads of information which will be helpful for you to become a Shopify developer, to become a good freelancer, and earn some more money. Thank you. Okay, guys, so open up a new tab and search for Shopify partners. So we'll have to sign up to Shopify partners in order to create our development store. So after searching for Shopify partners, you will see a link on the top. I would like you to click on that link and then click on join now. And once you click on join now, you can select continue with Google. After that, it will ask you which email. If you have already logged into your multiple emails, I'll select one of my email. And now it will show up the big form which you need to fill in. Most of them are optional fields, but some of the details are really important. So for example, in business name, I'll just add YouTube tutorial, as I'm creating a YouTube tutorial for you guys. And website, I'll leave it blank. Address, just add in any address. I'm just adding my city name for now. Okay, what is the primary plan? I'm building themes for the Shopify store. What is your current level of experience? I have experience building Shopify theme. I'll leave this one blank, select I'm not working with any e-commerce platform, and then click on I have read and agreed. Now, after filling everything up, click on view your dashboard. Oops, we left one of the important field, and just add in this and go back again, click on view your, okay. We will have to fill in all these details. Developer, phone number 123123. And that's it. Okay, click on view your dashboard. There we go. Our information has been saved and we are being redirected to our Shopify partners. So here's how the Shopify partners dashboard will look like. And from there, click on stores. And then add a store. Now, as you can see, we are seeing two options. One option is that we are a development store. If we are developing a theme for our client, or if we are doing code samples for ourselves, if we are doing code editing for ourselves and we are testing an app, Shopify app or a Shopify theme, we will select development store. And in case of managed store, so if your client already have a Shopify store up and running, and they want to change something in their Shopify store, you can select manage store and ask them for access, which is required. In our case, we are learning how to create a development store, but let's learn some of the stuff in manage store. So if you would like to add something on your client store and would like to have access to a theme label, you'll click on manage store, add in the store URL. So in this case, the development store which I have, that's my store URL. I'll just copy it and paste it here. And check mark all of the permission which I require in my case. So for example, if I need to add a theme, I'll click on themes. If you need to add products in your client store, you can check mark those things which you need access to and add an optional message and hit save. Once you hit save, Shopify will request that store owner to provide access to you. In our case, we are creating a development store. Now click on development store and here add in the store name like YouTube tutorial. And okay, this store URL is not available, so YouTube tutorial test, let's try that. Okay, that one is available, so it will automatically create a URL for you once you add in the store name. That is your email showing up. You can add in any password. I just added a random password. Okay, so that's the most important thing which you should know when you are creating a development store. If you check mark this option, you won't be able to transfer the ownership if you are creating a theme or creating a store for your customer. This is just for the developer preview, meaning you will have access to certain features which are currently in beta version, in beta mode, or not available publicly in order for you to test some of the stuff in your development store so you don't mess up anyone's live theme or anything like that. So if you are testing a feature which is not yet released from Shopify or an app which is not yet released and you do not want to transfer the ownership, you can simply check this thing. And if you are creating a store for your client where you will need to transfer the ownership, you will have to leave it blank. Cool, we'll leave it blank for now. And as now it's asking what stuff you are looking to get done with this development store, we will just mention that I am just playing around, right? Okay, now click save. And here we go. Our development store is ready to go. Click on this eye icon and looks like okay, it's saying shop has no theme, so our development store is ready. Click on online store. And here now it says Dawn is added just 1 minute ago. And okay, now let's try view your store now. And here we go. Our development Shopify store is ready to go, where you can add product, you can customize your theme, you can customize your Shopify app and try play around with it. If you like this tutorial, feel free to comment in the video below, like it, share it, and do not forget to subscribe my channel. Have a great day.